Welcome back. Just in closing, here is the lady who's going to take over from me. And I should tell you that there's a little hiatus going to take place, though, over the next, I think it's 3 weeks. And then on February 10th, which is a Monday, Sylvia Kuzik steps in with a brand new show, which will replace this one. And thank you for giving us the final few minutes this morning, because I know you're very busy.
That's no problem. It's an honor for me to be here. And I must say that this is a very emotional day for all of the studio crew and your guests that you have had on the last few tapings. And it's really emotional. It's pretty sad to see you go, Ray.
I think, though, that for me, as an example, if I begin to feel that sort of a little freshness has gone out of me, and I think I have noticed that, I suspect maybe the audience notices, too. So maybe the right day has come.
Oh, you're being hard on yourself, Ray. How do you feel about today? How do you feel about this last taping? I mean, are you excited about your retirement? Are you apprehensive?
I'm not apprehensive, and I look forward to it very much. I'm particularly looking forward to a couple of things that I never had time to do because I was too busy earning a living. And now I'm going to be able to do them. So I'm looking forward to that.
Well, Ray, we all wish you the very, very best. It's going to be very strange because you've been the voice of CKY TV for so long now that it just won't be the same.
Let me tell you that there are people out there who feel it's been too long. let me ask you this. Now, there's going to be a little hiatus here. I think it's about 3 weeks, isn't it?
Yes.
And then on Monday, February 10, you'll start with your new program. I'd like to make it clear to this audience that it is a new program, isn't it? New
yes.
title, it's going to be a new format, it'll be entirely your program, so you're not just taking over another vehicle.
I'm going to utilize my news hour resources and try to make it sort of an extension of the news so that we can go into more depth on various news-related stories. I would like to interview some interesting guests in sort of a profile setting as well, as you've done in the past. And I've got some rather exciting guests lined up for my first couple of tapings. Bromwell Tovey, Timothy Finley, Stephen Shipper, Ron Paley, and it's really going to be a kind of a cultural first set of shows. And from there, Bob Essenza as well. We want to get a sports figure in there, too.
So you'll do a little sports
as
well.
Yeah, I want a real variety of guests. And
that's a nice rounded format, I must say.
I want to have fun with it, but at the same time, I want to provide information. I want to do a regular health series. Which will probably be...
Well, that's a hot topic, of course.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Absolutely.
Are you going to have Bramwell play a little Gershwin?
I'd love to have him play a little Gershwin.
Oh, you must do that. Oh,
we'll have to roll in our piano if it's tuned.
Oh, have him play Gershwin. Yeah, because, you know, A, he loves Gershwin.
Yes.
And B, he plays it wonderfully well.
I know. Yeah. I've seen some video of him playing. He's just an amazing showman.
Yeah. Yeah. Since you're going to try a little sports in there as well... you're going to have to call on your resources, I guess, from the Suppertime News Hour with Peter Young's background and all of the folks in the sports department.
I want to focus on sports, but I want to do it maybe in a slightly different way. What's behind the person we see out there in the net, for example? What makes you tick? And what's like being a goalie? Are you sort of isolated in a way from the other players to a certain extent? You know, lots of different things. And perhaps his wife as well. What's it like being married to a celebrity like this? Getting into various aspects of the sports world, not just the playing sports.
Yeah, you know, you're quite right. Sometimes you see a goalie and he's having a bad night and he lets a whole bunch in and you say to yourself, I wonder what he feels like.
Exactly.
Because all of the fans, maybe 3,000 or 4,000 of them, are sitting there watching.
Booing him and jeering and what goes on in his mind in a moment like that.
And his teammates wish they'd given him better defense and all of that. Mm-hmm. You really do wonder how the guy feels. Yeah. Well, good luck. You take it over and really make a big success of it, eh?
Oh, thank you, Ray. Good luck to you.
Thank you very much.
You're going to be very missed.
Okay. I hope so. Thank you, Sylvia.
Thank you, Ray.
In 3 weeks, you understand. Join Sylvia in 3 weeks on February 10th.